από εδώ εκεί μόνο.
Δεν θα μπορώ εγώ εκεί.
Θα τα κάνω λίγο πιο εδώ και να βρείτε.
Είσαι εντάξει.
Hola, Martina. Hola.
Garrett, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being here this morning. Today's schedule starts with the presentation of the exercises Heroes 2021. By the commander of 114 Combat Wing, and will be followed by keynote speeches from the leadership. Please, I ask you to silence your phones and keep your attention to the commander of 114 Combat Wing, Colonel Dimitri Georgiou.
Honorable Minister of Defense, Minister of National Defense, Ambassador to France, distinguished visitors, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to 114 Combat Wing. For the next 5 minutes, I will brief regarding Skiros exercise. This exercise will enhance the level of interoperability and will allow the development of a common operational picture among the participants. In addition, the exercise is a tactical confirmation of the particular core relations between the two forces of the two countries, which are held by the same principles and values and will demonstrate in practice their respect to international law and regional and global stability. Participants from Greece, most of the Hellenic Tactical Air Force assets, 2 ships from the Hellenic Navy, and the team from Special Forces Command. The Guard of France, 2 Rafales, 2 A400s, 1 Airbus 330 MRTT for air-to-air refueling barrels, plus the appropriate money. The exercises started on Tuesday and it will be last up tomorrow, February the 5th. As you can see, a variety of exercises have arranged, giving the opportunity to all participants to be trained, receiving the maximum benefit. On Tuesday, February the 2nd, 2 events were taken place. On the first event, 2 Mirage 2000-5s performed an air-to-air refueling training in cooperation with MRTT at the flying area east of Peloponnesus. A French Air Force instructor pilot was flying in the back seat of 1 Mirage. While during the second event, 2 Mirage joined and escorting the 4 Rafales from Carnotos Island to Skiros and then to Tanagra Thalatta. Yesterday, during the first wave, the exercise scenario was plotted over flying areas west of Peloponnesus and included three main objectives. The first objective was again air-to-air refueling training with the participation of two Mirage 2005s, six F-16s from Araxos Air Base, four Rafales, and the Airbus 330 MRTT. The second objective was the protection from four Rafales and two Mirage 2005s of a high-value asset target, plainly certain known the A400, against six F-16s from Araxos Air Base. Last objective, and the most unusual, was a photo shooting of a mixed formation over at the geological site of Delphi, a place where the ancient Greeks considered as the center of the world. Participants were most of the previous mentioned aircrafts, and the formations depicted on the slide, with a small modifications since the A400 and the MRTT changed positions. During the second wave event, two Mirage 2005s and 12 F-16s from Almiros, Larissa and Suata air bases performed air-to-air fuel training in cooperation with the MRTT at flying areas east of Peloponnesus. Today, the flight schedule has two main events. The first event took place at Northern Aegean Seas, two Rafales, two Mirage 2000s and two F-16 from Larissa Air Base were trying to destroy two warships, one frigate and one guided missile patrol boat, which were area protected from four F-16s from Almiros Air Base. Finally, the second current event is unwaving over central Greece, where four Mirage 2005s and four F-16s from Almiros Air Base are trying to attack Kotanaga Air Base. Four Rafales and two F-16s from Araxos Air Base are tasking to prevent this to happen, flying at protected area of public possibility. By the end of the air-to-air scenario, F-16 from Almiros Air Base will perform air-to-ground attacks in cooperation with Special Forces team. As I mentioned before, all the variety of flying missions were planned this week, giving to all personnel the opportunity to be trained on a realistic battlefield. At this point, my brief is concluded. Please allow me to express my esteem to all of you and convey my warmest wishes to you and your families.
Honorable Defense Minister, Ambassador of France, sir, distinguished guests, it is with great joy and an immense pride that the French Air Force and Space Force is finishing Skyros, our operational projection of power mission here in Greece. This last stop is the perfect demonstration of the extremely positive momentum that our two air forces have experienced lately. This momentum is largely due to the long history of cooperation that exists between the French Air and Space Force and the Hellenic Air Force. But the bond just grows stronger with the recent choice by Greece to operate another French aircraft, the Rafale, which is a game changer. In the wake of the very recent decision, the Skyros mission, composed of one MRTT, two A400M and four Rafale, as well as over 150 aviators, is the immediate illustration of the kind of support the French Air and Space Force has in store for its Greek counterpart in order to fully exploit the potential of the flagship of the French military aviation, which has already proven itself on many occasions in operations. After landing successively in Djibouti, India, Emirates and Egypt, all of them our partners concerned with the security and stability in their respective regions, it was only natural that our last stopover was here in Greece, where our aircraft were able to land on one of the bases of the Hellenic Air Force, our ally, our partner, but overall our friends. Seeing our four Rafale land on Tanagra Air Base, home to the Mirage 2000, was a glimpse of the future. And for our crews, a true honor. This aircraft has been a real game changer for the French Air Force since 2006. And it triggered such an amazing response during each of our stops. Soon its wings will show the Greek colors and it makes us proud. Skyros is the breaking ground, first step marking the beginning of all opportunities of training together. They will contribute to making our bonds stronger through the development of a complete interoperability between the units operating the Rafale and through the countless occasion of a seamless common exercises, thanks to our common vector. Even before Skyros entered the skies of our magnificent, history-rich country, our crews have started training together. The Greek Mirage 2000 performed an air-to-air refueling as soon as the MRTT was in your airspace. And yesterday, our air crews performed a tactical flying training followed by the yet another air-to-air refueling before all aircraft, Greek and French, formed up to overfly Delphi. As I was lucky enough to witness the scene from the cockpit of the MRTT, I can assure you that the scene was breathtaking and was the vibrant example of how close our two air forces. During that last stop in Greece, pilots from the Hellenic Air Force were able to take place aboard the Rafale and fly with our pilots. Those flights, I was told, were rich in exchanges and in the experience shared between us. It is the setting in which the French Air and Space Force has already confirmed its participation in Exercise Iniopos in April, and in which we will reiterate the training completed in France during Exercise Wolfa, led by the French Air and Space Force. To conclude, we are particularly happy to welcome the Hellenic Air Force into the Rafale users team. Be assured that we are entirely open to the perspective of an active cooperation that will allow us to train side by side in order to achieve victory together in the operation of tomorrow. Thanks a lot.
Minister of National Defense, Chief of Hellenic National Defense General Staff, Secretary General, Your Excellency, Ambassador, Chiefs of Hellenic Army and Hellenic Navy General Staffs, Dear Generals, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great pleasure and honor for me to welcome you at 114 Combat Wing and to extend my gratitude for your presence here today. As your investment in time represents the presence of Skyros exercise. This is an exercise that aims to the co-training between the Hellenic and the French Air and Space Forces, which is conducted with great success and is proving as particularly beneficial for all participants. Exercise Skyros is a tangible confirmation of the excellent cooperation between our forces, of our nations, which share the same values and prove in practice their respect to international law as well as their commitment to regional and global stability. In this regard, Exercise Skyros sends a clear message that demonstrates our credibility and capability to address current and future air threats, while also instilling synergy at all armed forces levels. Given the fact that Hellenic Naval, as well as Special Forces, also participate in the exercise and operate together with Rafale, Mirage, F-16s, A330 Kangaroo, A400 and Airborne Early Warning aircrafts. High-profile exercises such as Olfa, Ineos, and today Skiros give the opportunity to our air crews to work as team, to fly together within mixed fighter formations, and to operate with safety and efficiency, implementing advanced air tactics. Through realistic air training in a multi-threat environment, we managed to develop a common operational understanding and to enhance interoperability and connectivity of our assets. Assets such as the Rafale aircraft, which will shortly be the state of the art of the Hellenic Air Force arsenal. Rafale aircraft is an air platform that incorporates such technological innovations that will enable the rapid and efficient response to any emerging threat within the Hellenic Flight Formation region and up Eastern Mediterranean. The advanced operational capabilities of the aircraft, in conjunction with each weapons, will ensure superiority and dominance in the air domain and will support our deterrence objectives. Capitalizing on the key advantage of air power, it can deliver strategic effects across the full spectrum of air operations, from strategic attacks up to air operation against naval, surface, and within ranges, the exert of one of our potential adversaries. In addition, it is worthy to mention that the acquisition of Rafale is a historical moment for the Hellenic Air Force. It is the very first acquisition of any along with their work, combined with a follow-on support, opens the gate to the future for our Air Force and changes the balance in our region. Honored Minister of National Defense, Your Excellency Ambassador, your presence today underlines the excellent cooperation and commitment to common joint exercise, giving a clear message of the solidarity and coherence of our nations to defend regional peace and stability. At this point, I would like to congratulate French and Hellenic Air Force personnel for the successful planning and execution of Skiros exercise and to renew our appointment for our next co-training event, which will be in Ineos exercise, planned to take place at Hellenic Air Force Air Tactics Center at Atravit Air Base in April 2021. Fully confident that we will continue to accomplish our missions successfully, developing our war-fighting mentality and prevailing in every domain that we are called to operate, I welcome you once again. I wish safe flights and successful missions. Thank you very much.
Bonjour à tous. Είμαι πολύ χαρούμενος και ευχαριστημένος να είμαι εδώ σήμερα. Minister of Defense Διανίκος, Joint Chief of Staff, dear General Floros, Air Force Chief of Staff, Commander, pilots, and personnel of the Tanagra base, General Lerbet, pilote et personnel de l'armée de l'air française qui contribue chaque jour au respect de notre souveraineté et à la lutte contre toutes les menaces. Dear friends, I want to welcome you to the Rafale Club. Greece has made a bold choice to buy weapons of sovereignty and power. I do believe this is the relevant choice because it was raised before me. Greece has to face a regional environment that remains and will probably remain unstable and unpredictable. But ladies and gentlemen, Rafale is not only an arms deal. With and beyond the Rafale, France does offer to Greece its strategic partnership. Basically, we share the same vision. Security in this part of the world is key for the whole European continent. The Greek and the French, we believe that stability should be grounded on international law, on the respect of sovereignty, and we do refuse intimidation, threats, and fait accompli. This is why, that was mentioned before, France has increased its military presence in this region. Today is about Air Force training, then again in April, with the exercise in Yorkos, then again in April, with the interactions between the aircraft carrier Charles de Gaulle and the Hellenic Navy. Minister Tinikos, I want to commend today again your leadership. I want to thank you. I want to thank the commanders of the Hellenic Armed Forces, because thanks to you, our bilateral relationship has turned to be a real strategic partnership. I do believe that our friendship deserves this partnership. I am happy and proud today because France has proved to be the oldest and the most reliable ally of Greece. The story began 200 years ago. You will celebrate this year this bicentennial. And as you all know, France was a great part of the Greek story. I do hope that we will see more Rafale in the Greek sky, more French frigates at sea, because I'm convinced that this is how we become brothers in arms. As we say, Minister, as we say, Elas, Dalia, Simashia. Ευχαριστώ πολύ.
Minister, Your Excellency, Mr. Ambassador, General Lebed, Mr. Secretary General, Chief of the Hellenic Army, Navy and Air Force, dear defending attachés, the personnel of the French and Hellenic Air Forces, dear press representatives, on behalf of the Hellenic Armed Forces, I welcome you all at the 114 Combat Wing in Tanagra on the outstanding occasion of skills exercise. For us Greeks, hospitality runs in our veins, so we are very pleased to host the French Air Force brilliant personnel and its excellent assets in Tanagra. Dear friends, I hope you are enjoying your short stay in Greece, considering the restrictions imposed by COVID-19. I sincerely hope that we will all overcome this pandemic soon and return to normal life.
First, it highlights the excellent relations of the UK and France and their armed forces, and signals the common willingness to strengthen their cooperation on defense. Second, it showcases Greece's confidence in France, as the Hellenic Air Force will be the first European Air Force, besides the French Air Force, of course, to own and operate in this aircraft. The Rafale fighter is a force multiplier and fits perfectly in the operational requirements defined in the first place by me personally, the Hellenic Air Force. And this is why I am extremely happy for this outstanding acquisition. I'm also confident that the aircraft itself, along with the follow-on support and its accompanying weapons, will prove to be a remarkable new asset to the Hellenic Air Forces. And it will be another great tool at our disposal in full harmonization with our commitment and dedication to continue promoting stability in our wider region, as well as securing the sovereign rights and sovereignty of my nation. Mr. Ambassador, distinguished friends from France, I would like to assure you that the Hellenic Air Forces are committed to the engagement of our bilateral military cooperation. We want to take advantage of all available opportunities for our forces to train and interact. We managed a lot during the last years despite the restrictions of the COVID-19 pandemic, and of course we will continue doing so this year. I believe that Greece and France, along of course with the countries represented here today and with others as well, share the same vision for security in the wider region. A vision that calls for the respect of each other and the international law as the required common denominator to safeguard security, peace and stability in the central and east Mediterranean. With that said, I would like to thank the French Armed Forces for their commitment and dedication to scheduling and participating in this training activity on a rather short notice. Concluding, I wish for the French Armed Forces the safe death back home. And please mark my words, as my message to all of you is that you and your colleagues are and will always be most welcome to Greece. Thank you all for being here today, and congratulations to all participants for the great success and achievement of this exercise. Thank you very much.
The right to see this ambassador of France. Honorable Chief of National Defense, General Staff, Honorable Secretary of the Ministry of Defense, Honorable Chiefs of the Air, Navy and Army, General Staff, General de Division Arien de la Rebellion de l'Espace de France, men and women of the Hellenic Air Force and the French Armée de l'Air, ladies and gentlemen, permettez-moi d'abord des mots en français. Κυρία τα μεξιέ, τον Σαμίτα Σαντιέ, αβιαντέρα και ουσιαν φρανσές που έχουν participé dans cette preuve excellente de puissance aérienne. Cet exercice est la preuve du partenariat stratégique toujours croissant entre la Grèce et la France. C'est également une excellente occasion pour nous, un an de pays, de développer des relations plus étroites, de renforcer notre disponibilité et notre interopérabilité au niveau tactique et opérationnel, mais aussi d'envoyer en même temps un message clair de nos capacités de dissuasion. Avec un niveau de coopération aussi élevé, nous sommes fermement convaincus qu'ensemble, nous pouvons faire face à toute menace dans la région. Ladies and gentlemen, let me say how pleased I am to attend today here the historic Magyar Airways, the Distinguished Visitors Day exercise Skiros 21. This exercise is a very strong proof of the ever-growing strategic partnership between Greece and France. It is also a great opportunity for our two countries to come together and strengthen our readiness and interoperability at the tactical and operational level, while at the same time send a clear message of our defense capabilities. It is an opportunity for the Air Force of the two countries to promote mutual cooperation in a multiple threat environment, upgrade the quality of their respective training, while allowing us to train our crews in complex missions with I believe it's very important to highlight that there, here actually, from this base, in the next month, the Hellenic Air Force will operate the Greek Rafale, continuing the long tradition of the French fighter aircraft in the Greek Air Force and in another air base in particular. A tradition that began in the 1970s with the acquisition of the Mirage F1 aircraft and continued through the following decades with the Mirage 2000 and the Mirage 2000-5 that we see around us behind us. With this exercise, our pilots get the first acquaintance of the capabilities of the new aircraft that we recently agreed to procure. It is a procurement that could not have been accomplished within such a short period of time without the significant contribution of the French Ministry of Defense and the French Air Force, of course. A fact which proves that Greece and France have established an excellent framework of military cooperation, which enables us to ensure, strengthen, and consolidate a safer geopolitical environment in our broader region. It is obvious that our joint effort has recently brought significant milestones in our bilateral defense cooperation. I'm grateful that I'm given today the opportunity once again to witness the accomplishments of the armed forces of our two countries in operating together, demonstrating their excellent operational and tactical skills, as well as the high level of training. With such a high level of cooperation, we are confident that together we can confront any threat in the region. France and Greece jointly promote cooperation in many levels and areas, and are committed to join.
Και γιατί δεν το βάζω εκεί πέρα,
ρε. Δεύτερη μπαλαντέζα.
Όχι, ναι ρε, αμέσως ρε, δεν τρέπεστε κα κεντρική στήπη.
Σήμερα πολιτική και στρατηγική ηγεσία του Υπουργείου Εθνικής Άμυνας την ημέρα διακεκριμένων επισκεπτών της άσκησης Κύρος 21 στην αεροπορική βάση της Τανάγρας στην 114 πτέρυγα μάχης. Μια άσκηση στην οποία συμμετείχαν δυνάμεις της γαλλικής και ελληνικής πολεμικής αεροπορίας αλλά και μονάδες του πολεμικού ναυτικού και των ειδικών δυνάμεων σε κάποια από τα σενάρια της. Η άσκηση αυτή είναι μια εξέχουσα ευκαιρία για τις δύο χώρες να έρθουν πιο κοντά και να αναπτύξουν τρόπους προσέγγισης σε τακτικό και επιχειρησιακό επίπεδο και επιπλέον να στείλουν ένα σαφές μήνυμα της αποτρεπτικής μας δύναμης. Είναι μια ευκαιρία οι πολεμικές αεροπορίες των δύο χωρών να προωθήσουν την αμοιβαία συνεργασία σε ένα περιβάλλον πολλαπλών απειλών, αναβαθμίζοντας την ποιότητα της εκπαίδευσής τους, ενώ επιπρόσθετα επιτρέπει και σε εμάς να συντηρήσουμε τη διαθεσιμότητα των πληρωμάτων μας σε σύνθετες αποστολές. Μεταξύ αυτών και ο ανεφοδιασμός των αεροσκαφών στον αέρα. Είναι επίσης σημαντικό ότι από τη βάση αυτή σε λίγους μήνες θα επιχειρούν και τα πρώτα ελληνικά Ραφάλ, συνεχίζοντας τη μακρά παράδοση αξιοποίησης γαλλικών μαχητικών αεροσκαφών από την ελληνική πολεμική αεροπορία. Μια παράδοση που ξεκίνησε τη δεκαετία του 1970 με την απόκτηση των αεροσκαφών Mirage F1 και συνεχίστηκε τις επόμενες δεκαετίες με τα Mirage 2000 και τα Mirage 2000-5 που ακόμα υπηρετούν την πολεμική αεροπορία. Με τη σημερινή άσκηση, οι αεροπόροι μας παίρνουν μια πρόγευση των δυνατοτήτων των νέων αεροσκαφών, η προμήθεια των οποίων συμφωνήθηκε πρόσφατα και εγκρίθηκε από τη Βουλή των Ελλήνων. Και είναι μια προμήθεια που η ταχύτητα με την οποία θα ολοκληρωθεί οφείλεται μεταξύ άλλων και στην πολύ σημαντική συμβολή του Γαλλικού Υπουργείου Άμυνας. Γεγονός που αποδεικνύει ότι με την πάροδο του χρόνου έχουμε δημιουργήσει με τη Γαλλία ένα σταθερό και συνεχώς αναπτυσσόμενο πλαίσιο στρατιωτικής συνεργασίας, με το οποίο εξασφαλίζουμε, ενισχύουμε και εδραιώνουμε ένα ασφαλέστερο γεωπολιτικό περιβάλλον στην περιοχή μας. Είναι επίσης προφανές ότι η κοινή μας προσπάθεια έχει φέρει σημαντικά επιτεύγματα και είμαι ευγνώμων που μου έχει δοθεί η ευκαιρία για μια ακόμα φορά να παρακολουθήσω τις ένοπλες δυνάμεις των δύο χωρών να αναπτύσσονται παράλληλα, επιδεικνύοντας τις εξαιρετικές επιχειρησιακές τους ικανότητες και το υψηλό επίπεδο εκπαίδευσης που τους δίνει την ετοιμότητα να αντιμετωπίσουν τις προκλήσεις ασφαλείας στην περιοχή μας. Η Ελλάδα τον τελευταίο καιρό είναι αποδέκτης πολλαπλών απειλών και καλείται καθημερινά να τις αντιμετωπίσει, διασφαλίζοντας σταθερότητα, την ανάπτυξη και την ευημερία στην ευρύτερη περιοχή. Η Γαλλία και η Ελλάδα από κοινού προωθούν την αμοιβαία συνεργασία και στον τομέα αυτό, ενεργώντας ταυτόχρονα ως αποφασιστικοί παράγοντες σταθερότητας και ασφάλειας στην Ανατολική Μεσόγειο, στη βάση του διεθνούς δικαίου και σύμφωνα με τις αρχές της καλής γειτονίας. Συγχαίρω λοιπόν το προσωπικό της Γαλλικής Πολεμικής Αεροπορίας αλλά και των ενόπλων δυνάμεών μας που συμμετείχαν στην άσκηση για την εξαιρετική τους απόδοση, προετοιμασία και οργάνωση. Σας ευχαριστώ.